gear ratios. What are they? How do I calculate them? What does it have to do with gears? How does this work? We'll see all of this very quickly after the intro. Welcome back to the Omni Calculator channel. I'm Alvaro, this is our gear ratio calculator, and today we're going to explain what it does, how to use it, why you would want to use it, and give you a short example of using it all in just 90 seconds, which start now. So let's start with the what. When we have a two-gear system, one where we put the energy and another one where we get that energy, so input and output, unless the number of teeth in each gear is the same, their speed and their torque is going to be different. And this relationship is governed by the gear ratio, which you can calculate very easily just by inputting the number of teeth of each gear into our calculator. This number can also be expressed as mechanical advantage, but that's more relevant for pulleys and levers, which you can learn more about there. For us, we can move into the second section where we have this input and output speed and torque. So just when we have the gear ratio, just by putting the input speed or the input torque, we can get the output speed or torque. And we can use this calculator in the opposite way. So we can say what output do we want, and it would tell us what input we need. And this goes into the why you would want to use this calculator. Obviously for school assignments, this is marvelous. I mean, nobody likes to do calculations by hand, but it can also help you understand and design gear systems. So for example, if I know what input and output torque I want, I can just define one of the gears and the calculator would define the other gear for me and tell me what I need to build. And it can also help us understand gear systems like bicycles, for example. If I'm going on a flat road, I can use a 50 tooth at the front and a 10 at the back, and it would take a lot of effort to move the pedals, but I would go very fast. And if I'm going up a slope, I need a lot of torque, so I would put a 34 at the back and a 30 at the front, and I would spin very fast, but with a lot of torque. Yes! So we just barely made it into the 90 seconds, and that was not everything there is to know about this topic, but for that, we have a thorough text in our website, so go check the link in the video description. Also, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this, and go check out some of the videos we've made in the past. This is what I recommend, this is what YouTube recommends. I have no idea which one's better, but you can let me know in the comments. In any case, I will see you in the next video. Bye!